Fantastic seeing you here. 18 months ago, we were getting ready for a concert. I was teaching at school, I went home, and I'm back. The last 18 months have been very interesting. I finally retired while I was took this little time off, so it took me till I was 72 to figure out retirement might be a good idea, but that works. But I didn't retire from this group. In fact, my wife and I, Diane, moved to Madison, Wisconsin, in the area. There we're in Stoughton, actually, with a bunch of Norwegians. And we're having a good time there, and it's fun coming back for rehearsals every week and coming back to do this. And I can't tell you, as a band here, and we discovered when we had our first rehearsal back in September, it felt so very, very good. It's so good to be able to get out and get to see everyone and get back with people. And now we have a live audience to play for. This is like, you know, this is almost beyond belief. A couple things I want to mention. This is a memorial concert, and we will eventually be having a free will offering that will be going down the line, so we'll figure out how to do that while we're doing the concert. But beyond that, this memorial concert is in honor of many of our members that we've had. Normally this concert, we have a guest musician that comes in from across the country, somewhere in the country, and we perform with a bunch of high school students, and it's at Park High School. It's been there for 20 years, so this is the first time we've not been there for that type of concert. But I'm really looking forward to this. But one of the things that we're doing today is, as part of this memorial concert is, we have all survived many things, but we have also, over the years, lost a few members, and we also have, later in the program, I'll make mention of Veterans Day coming up. But right now, I'd like to make mention of the members that we have had in this group that we have lost during the period of time that I've been directing, in fact, just slightly before when I was directing. The following people: Ken Stearns, Ed Kniestein, Pete Dupuy, known as Pete Dupas by some people, Phil Davis, Val Hoff, Brad Hutchinson, Steve Shaning, one of our founders, Johnny Hempkes, who had been with us for many, many years, Harlow Klima, who he and I set the stage for almost every concert for 15 to 20 years, Roger Paulman from Paulman Chevrolet, Marilyn Marvica, who was from Park High School and played in the French horn section, Mr. Ed Burglis, who passed away this past year in Florida, Bill McElvain, and just recently we lost Kenny Norman during this past year, and we played for his funeral, and we'll be doing another service for the president of our group, Gary King, who passed away shortly after the outbreak came through. These people are very important people in our lives, and I'm sure you have had many very important people in your lives that we've seen pass in the past year and a half and in the past few years. And this is a memorial concert, but it's also, you'll notice one of the pieces of music that's in there called Fiesta de la Vida. It's a celebration of life. And that's what I really want to make sure that you understand, that this is really a celebration of life. We're back together again, and I can't wait to perform for you. Our first selection for you is going to be This Is My Father's World, Bell City Brass Works.
Thank you.
Okay, in a minute, get the break. I'm taking the break here. Huh. You know, when you haven't directed for 16, 18 months, it takes it out of you. But other than that, the next selection applies to many of us, all of us, my way. It was written and eventually performed by Frank Sinatra, but he was never really happy with the piece. It became his signature piece, but he was not thrilled with it. He thought it was a little too schmaltzy. But My Way speaks to all of us, because we all do things our way. We've worked through many, many things in our lives, and we have some very interesting personalities. If you ever want to meet interesting personalities, become a conductor. There are a lot of personalities back there, and some of them get reputations just by the instrument they play. Flute players draw little pictures of fawns and flowers on their music. And I guarantee you, you go to any band program or orchestra program in the United States, grab the flute part out, and you'll see little flowers on it. It's almost always guaranteed. And there are, you know, comments about tubas and percussion and trombones and all of us in the band. But it's one of the most interesting personalities we had in this group was a young man by the name of Kenny Norman. And Kenny was anything besides normal. Kenny could do things in music that all of us wish we could. He could sit down and write a piece of music in a few seconds flat for you and write it in any key and change the parts as you're performing, and had a great time doing that. But he spoke on a different plane than the rest of this world. When you had a conversation with Kenny, you worked very hard trying to figure out what he was exactly saying. And sometimes he got a little blunt, right? I mean, just a tad blunt. And it wasn't because he was being mean or anything, he just lacked that ability to say things without just kind of coming straight through. But he was fun to be with. He was a fantastic musician. I knew him since my days at UW Parkside, when we first got back there in 1967. And he was as much fun and as wild and crazy then as he was to the last day of his life. So this piece is kind of dedicated to Kenny, but it's also dedicated to all of us, My Way.
Thank you.
We'll try this again. This next election is entitled Fiesta de la Vida, a celebration of life. And it is a fantastic tune. We've really enjoyed doing this. It's got a lot of different things happening in it throughout, rhythms that are fantastic, complex. And if it doesn't take you to a beach somewhere, we have failed in our attempt, because I think you're going to absolutely love what this piece does. Fiesta de la Vida.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to get back to this. This is for the audience and the band to come back and join us. This is like old home week, visiting everybody we haven't seen for a long time. It is. It's great to be with people again. And I have to tell you, I mean, when I went from working 5 days a week and rehearsing 3 nights a week and a performance every other weekend, which I'd been doing for the better part of 30 years, 40 years, to March 14th, go home and sit down, and then come here and do this concert. I mean, that's basically what it felt like. It was such a shock to end at that time. And I hope you enjoyed the Fiesta de la Vida. That's a fun piece. I was on the beach. By the way, my grandson, my oldest grandson, Tyler, was married last November. Was supposed to get married in June. And he asked me to be his best man at his wedding, which was fantastic. We had a great time. But we ended up having the wedding a year ago this week up in Stevens Point. It was 65 degrees. We went golfing the day before in the middle of November. We thought that was terrific. And we all had a great time, cut the list down so that people wouldn't get sick and everything, and everybody wore masks. And then the party happened in the evening, and still everybody was kind of wearing masks. And then right near the end, they weren't. That's okay, except for the 8 of us who were all the wedding party who got sick from COVID. There were 8 of us that came down with it. My wife and I were 2 of them. She was 2 weeks in the hospital. I spent 3 days. And I'll tell you this much. I'm an advocate for the shot. I was quickly to get the shot after that, and I made sure that everybody that I knew could get the shots, because you don't want this. You don't ever want this. And if anything, I think this gave all of us a pause, time to sit back and enjoy our lives and enjoy our friends and really think about what we're doing. I think a lot of people that were working too hard are no longer working too hard. They've decided, maybe I need some more time for my family. And if anything good came from that, maybe that's it. But I'm really happy to be here. I want to thank Sacred Heart Church for everything they're doing for us. And Father, Ricardo is back there doing recording, so he's been coming back and helping us out and making sure that we can do this. This is our performance venue. And we're looking forward again to doing quite a few other things. We're going to be doing the concert here at Christmas, the Christmas season on a Wednesday. I think it's the 22nd. Thank you. And I'm looking forward to having a nice packed house and everybody singing in every other row. So we're going to expand you everywhere in here and do that. By the way, I never let the audience get away without singing. That includes this concert. Which song would that be? Bridge Over the River Kwai. How many of you can whistle? Get ready, because you're going to be the whistlers, okay? And I'll cue you when to come in. So, come back to our second half of our concert. Our first selection is Prelude, Dance in March. It is written by Sir Malcolm Arnold, who also wrote Bridge Over River Kwai in 1 week. He was given the job, and he did it out of spite. He was not a very happy man until he was much older. In his younger days, people were not thrilled with him, but they liked him enough as he got older that they made him Sir Malcolm Arnold, and he wrote fantastic music, and I'm sure you're going to love our performance of his music.
Thank you.
Must use the mic every time. Okay, thank you. That was really nice. Okay, here comes your part. You will get very good at this. We also will be having our free will offering during this piece of music, so you can still whistle and pass the basket, so that's not a problem. All right, we appreciate that. This piece, we did, Kenny Norman arranged this. Piece by Malcolm Arnold. He arranged it for us to do on a parade. We used to sit on a parade float and float through the parades out in Union Grove and at Waterford. I'm not sure we're going to be doing that again. We are aging up a little bit. And Kenny and Gary King were the ones that put the float together, organized all the things, and talked to everybody to get the stuff done. But I've never watched a parade because I find them very boring, but sitting on a float, it's much more fun. The only problem is every time you put your instrument down, the audience screams, play. You play, you put the instrument down, they yell, play. You play. You know, I had someone offer me a beer once. I thought that was very kind of them. But other than that, we play from the beginning to the end of the parade route, and then we just kind of collapse. And if it's a sunny day, it's the most horrible day for a parade is a sunny day. You want clouds, and you want a light breeze and the temperature in the 70s or 60s. That's perfect parade weather. Anybody that thinks sunny is nice on a parade, you haven't marched it. Don't do that. So when you do your next parade watching, make sure you ask for clouds. And we'll all be happy. Okay, so now, Colonel Boogie, this is one of our wonderful pieces, and from the Bridge on the River Kwai, which people got many Oscars for, and I think Sir Malcolm Arnold got one for the music in this piece of music. And you get to sing Oscar-level music. You get to whistle it. So I'll get you whistling when I need you. Here we go. Thank you. I appreciate your whistling. It was well done. A little bit flat over here, but we'll work on that next time. Other than that, we're in great shape. The next selection we're going to do for you came from, in my mind, from watching MASH on TV. And Father Mulcahy is talking about the Korean War, and he says they just don't have any good tunes about the war. You always had, you know, World War I had these tunes, World War II had these tunes, and they all sound happy and fine and wonderful. And then he talked, then he wrote a piece of music for the Korean War that he sat down at the piano and played, and it was a very sad and somber piece of music, more like what war is like for the people that are in it, the veterans. And this is what we're getting close to right now is Veterans Day, and that's kind of the reason I played River Kwai, is because of that military connection to that. And this piece of music, this is music from World War I, the war to end all wars. We've had a few of those. We haven't found the one yet that stops this from happening anymore, which we need desperately to have happen throughout the world. But this piece has got some music from the early days, and it's all English music except for one, which happens to be one of America's favorite tunes that our soldiers marched into war in World War I. So sit back and enjoy songs they took to war. Our next selection for you is In Memoriam, written by Jacob de Haan. And it's a very, very beautiful piece. And it's kind of like a conclusion to the concert. In Memoriam is for a Veterans Day, for us, for all of us. And it's Veterans Day here in the United States, but there are veterans throughout the world in many, many, many different countries who have fought for their families, fought for their freedoms, and their country's freedoms, not just us. Veterans everywhere. And they sacrificed for their beliefs. In Memoriam. for our final selection. We're going to do a piece that is entitled Service Medley. We usually do this at Memorial Day, and we do it a couple other times during the year. And we ask those of you that have served in the service, whether you're a member of the Coast Guard, Army, Navy, Air Force, or Marines, to stand when we play your song. All right, and the band will also have those members stand at that point for their part in participation as a member of the Armed Services. Again, I want to thank all of you for being here. Today is fantastic. We've had a great time performing. It's so nice to be back together again, and let's have some fun with Service Medley. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. It is so nice to be back together again and starting to come out of our little huts at home and visit with other people. Thank you again for coming. We're looking forward to performing for you soon in December. We have two Christmas concerts, one at Living Faith Lutheran Church, and the 15th of December and the 22nd here at Sacred Heart. Then we have a concert coming up, I believe, at the end of March, March 20. 7th, March 27th, and that will be at Living Faith Lutheran Church, and that's kind of going to be dedicated to Gary King, and we're going to do a lot of music from tremendously different fields, all the way from Park High School's fight song to drum corps music, to Madison Scouts music, to early Brassworks music, to concertos. So I know you're going to love that concert and all the ones in between. So thanks again for coming. Have a great Sunday. Thank you.